Sing praises to the living God, glory, alleluia. Come adore the living God, glory, alleluia. Though sun and moon may pass away, His word will ever stay. His power is forevermore, glory, alleluia. Glory to the Trinity, the undivided unity, the Father, Son, and Spirit one, from whom all life and goodness come.
This Mass is offered for the following intentions: birthday blessings for Sangeeta Tellis, Renny Peso, Dominic D'Souza, silver wedding anniversary blessings for Saika and Adrian Vasavkar, wedding anniversary blessings for Rudolph and Dominica D'Souza, Clive and Candida D'Souza, Zenaida and Royston Gracious, Christabel and Dominic and John Cupino, Brian and Avril Rodericks, Colin and Juliet Rodericks, Croydon and Michelle Byrne, wedding anniversary remembrance of Francis and Teresa Barrow, Dominic and Jennifer Furtado, good health and intentions of Norma and Danny D'Souza on their 51st wedding anniversary, Thanksgiving, good health and well-being of Silvera and Fernandez family, in Thanksgiving for healing Sharon, Justin, Wensi and family from COVID, souls of Robert Cooper, first death anniversary, Brass Amara, Eslinda Saldana, Senin Kathy D'Souza, Royce D'Souza, Kingsley Barrow, Simon Barrow. We also pray for all those who celebrate their birthdays and anniversaries today. All together, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the priceless communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, we are convinced Emmanuel, Jesus, is with us. To celebrate the sacred mysteries of this Eucharist in a worthy manner, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord's pardon and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. To my most grievous fault, therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us honor God by singing the Gloria.
Glory, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen, amen, amen.
Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that the newness of the nativity in the flesh of your only begotten Son may set us free, for ancient servitude holds us bound beneath the yoke of sin. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first letter of Saint John. I am writing to you, little children, because your sins are forgiven for his name's sake. I am writing to you, fathers, because you know him who is from the beginning. I am writing to you, young men, because you have overcome the evil one. I write to you, children, because you know the Father. I write to you, fathers, because you know him who is from the beginning. I write to you, young men, because you are strong, and the word of God abides in you, and you have overcome the evil one. Do not love the world or the things in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the desires of the flesh and the desires of the eyes and pride of life, is not from the Father, but is from the world. And the world is passing away along with its desires. But whoever does the will of God abides forever. The word of the Lord. Our response is, let the heavens rejoice and earth be glad. Kindly listen to the tune.
Let the heavens rejoice and earth be glad. Together. Let the heavens rejoice and earth be glad.
Give the Lord, you families of peoples, give the Lord glory and power. Give the Lord the glory of his name. Together.
Let the heavens rejoice and earth be glad.
Bring an offering and enter his courts. Worship the Lord in holy splendor. O tremble before him, all the earth. Together.
Let the heavens rejoice and earth be glad. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
A holy day has dawned upon us. Come, you nations, and adore the Lord. Today a great light has come upon the earth.
Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, there was a prophetess Anna, the daughter of Phanuel of the tribe of Asher. She was advanced in years, having lived with her husband 7 years, from when she was a virgin, and then as a widow until she was 84. She did not depart from the temple, worshipping with fasting and prayer night and day. And coming up at every hour, she began to give thanks to God and to speak of him to all who were waiting for the redemption of Jerusalem. And when they had performed everything according to the law of the Lord, they returned into Galilee to their hometown of Nazareth.
And the child grew and became strong, filled with wisdom, and the favor of God was upon him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Gospel passage, dear brothers and sisters, describe how prophetess Anna greets the promised Messiah when Joseph presented Mary, the mother of the child, for the purification and the redemption of the infant Jesus. Anna is 84-year-old, a widow. She lives in the temple, and all these years she has been praying, fasting and worshipping God, and her only desire is to see the promised Messiah. In his time, she is rewarded the joy of seeing the Messiah. And out of excitement, she praises God and also introduces the baby to others as the promised Messiah. Anna is a very simple, ordinary woman. History tells us how God chooses the simple and ordinary. God qualifies them when he calls them. He empowers them. He gives them the skills, gives them the fruits and charisms of the Holy Spirit, and makes them qualified to reach out to others in the name of Jesus. Dear brothers and sisters, Anna prayed. These days are difficult for us. Like Anna, we need to pray. We also need to see the power of prayer. Let us pray that every time we pray, we are hopeful and we believe in a God who has the power to save us. Amen.
Accept, Almighty Father, these gifts of bread and wine, which now the priest is offering for us before thy shrine. But soon the word will make them his body and his blood, the sacrifice renewing, once offered on the road.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For on the feast of this awe-filled mystery, though invisible in his own divine nature, he has appeared visibly in ours, and begotten before all ages, he has begun to exist in time, so that raising up in himself all that was cast down, he might restore unity to all creation and call strained humanity back to the heavenly kingdom. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come, until you come, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Oswald Gracious, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be your heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Manvite Manite, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
We make an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus,
I believe
that you are present.
That you are present
in the most holy sacrament.
The most holy sacrament.
I love you above all things.
I love you above all things.
And I desire
to receive you
into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment
receive you sacramentally,
come at least spiritually
into my heart.
I embrace you as if you are already there
and unite myself
holy to you.
Never permit me
to be separated from you. Amen.
O come, holy faithful, joyful and triumphant. O come me to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of ages. O come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord.
For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion,
Abba Father, have mercy on us and save us from the virus.
For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion,
Abba Father, have mercy on us and save us from the virus.
For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion,
Abba Father, have mercy on us and save us from the virus.
For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion,
Abba Father, have mercy on us and save us from the virus.
For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion,
Abba Father, have mercy on us and save us from the virus.
O God, who touch us who are partaking of your sacrament, work, we pray, the effects of his power in our hearts, that we may be made fit to receive your gift through this very gift itself, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you.
Blessed are the amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Our Lady of Mount Carmel,
pray for us. Long time ago in Bethlehem, in a manger poor and small, Mary's boy child, Jesus Christ, was born to die for all. Hark now, hear the angels sing, a new king's born today, that we may live forevermore because of Christmas Day. Trumpets sound and angels sing, listen to what they say, that we may live forevermore because of Christmas Day.